Good morning, students. Today we will study the use of potentiometer to compare the EMF of two cells. But the name of the method is called combination method. Another name of the method, combination method, is sum and difference method. Last lecture we have seen the individual cell method. In this lecture, we will compare the EMF of two cells but using what? Combination method. First, let us study the circuit diagram of potentiometer used as comparison of two cells using combination method. Students, this particular portion is same as the previous circuit diagram, that is individual cell method. Here we observe potentiometer wire PQ. It is connected in series with EMF of battery E, then plug key K, and rheostat RH. But the above portion, we observe that positive terminal of the battery E1 is connected to point P. This ABCD is a four-way key. The portion of this key A and C is to be what? Close either way, or B and D means at a time I will put a key on the arm A and C, that time B and D will be open, and if I put key into the arm B and D, that time A and C should be open. What is the use of this combination? I will explain you when I will explain the working of this particular circuit. Let us study the working of this particular circuit diagram, that is what, comparison of two EMF of two cells by combination method. Students, initially we will just put a key into the plug key K so that what, current will start flowing. Now we have to put a key, as I told you, I am going to insert a key in opposite arms. If I insert a key into the arms A and C, then this particular path is closed. The students, if you observe, positive terminal of E1 is connected to point P, negative terminal of E1 is connected to what? A, first point of this particular part. Then this part is closed, then it's connected to what? Positive terminal of what? E2. Means what? We observe that if this path is closed, negative terminal of E1 is connected to the positive terminal of E2. And further, negative terminal of E2 is connected to by this path, and it is connected to what? Galvanometer. So this particular combination, plus minus, plus minus, you will see here, plus minus, then A, plus minus. This combination is a series combination in a such a way that this is what? E1 plus E2. But this combination will give us, when I insert key A and C, I will get net EMF is what? E1 plus E2. Student, same thing, once you get E1 plus E2, then I am going to connect this jockey to the point P and Q such a way that you will get extreme left and extreme right deflection. If you don't get, adjust the rheostat. Once you get extreme left and right deflection, then start sliding the jockey on the wire PQ till you will get the point P1. P1 is that point where galvanometer will show zero deflection. Means it is balancing length you got between P and P1. The voltage between P and P1 is what? E1 plus E2. According to principle of potentiometer, The voltage between point P and P1 is directly proportional to the length between points P and P1. I will show in mathematical format, in mathematically. E1 plus E2 equal to what? Voltage between P and P1, say number 1. Then according to principle of potentiometer, voltage between P and P1 is directly proportional to length L1. If I remove the proportionality, then proportionality constant will come, that is what, K into what, L1, where K is called potential gradient. As I mentioned in the last lecture, potential gradient. Then from 1 and 2, I'm going to replace V P P1 by what? E1 plus E2. The E1 plus E2 is what? K times of L1. Students, now we will insert a key in the arm B and D. B and D. Remove the key from A and C. Put key into the arm B and D. So we observe that this is closed now. This is closed now. So students, now all of you concentrate here. Negative terminal of E1, now this is open now. Okay, now it is connected to what? This particular path. This is open, huh? This is open, totally open. Now this blue part represent the connection from here to here. So means what? Negative terminal of E1 is connected via D to negative terminal of E2, and the positive terminal of E2 connected to via B towards what? Galvanometer. Means negative terminal of E1 is connected to what? Negative terminal of E2. This combination I will show here. This is a bat EMF of E1 cell. Negative terminal of E1 is connected via path D, and negative terminal of E2 and positive terminal of E2 connected to what? Galvanometer G via path B. This particular combination is, student, E1 minus E2. Some students will ask, sir, why not E2 minus E1? So here I am going to tell you, I am going to consider E1 is greater than E2. That's why E1 minus E2. Sign of the greater number. That is what? E1 minus E2. The students, now due to E1 minus E2, due to E1 minus E2, this particular D and B part, same procedure I'm going to follow. I'm going to connect this jockey towards point P and Q. I will get what? Left and right deflection. If I am unable to get, then I will adjust the rheostat so that I will get left, extreme left and extreme right deflection. Then slide the jockey on the wire PQ till you will get point P2 such a way that a galvanometer will show zero deflection. Galvanometer will show zero deflection means the voltage between point P and P2 is equal to E1 minus E2. But according to principle of potentiometer, voltage between P and P2 is directly proportional to the length between points P and P2. I will show mathematically. So E1 minus E2 is what? Voltage between P and P2, and which is directly equals to what? K times of L2. This is, say, expression number 4. Divide 3 and 4. So E1 plus E2 is the left hand side of equation 3. E1 minus E2 is left hand side of equation 4. What right hand side here? KL1 upon what? KL2. KK get cancelled. So E1 plus E2 upon E1 minus E2 equals to what? L1 upon L2. Then we will apply componendo and dividendo rule. It states that E1 plus E2 plus E1 minus E2 means what? Numerator plus denominator upon numerator minus denominator is equals to L1, same L1, that is numerator plus denominator, numerator minus denominator. So here we observe that E2, it cancel, E1 plus E1, 2 times of E1. If I shift minus sign inside, then E1, E1 get cancelled. This minus minus plus E2 plus E2, 2 times of E1 is equals to L1 plus L2 upon L1 minus L2. 2 get cancelled. So students, by using sum and difference method, we can compare two EMF of two cells by this formula. Thank you very much.